straight on with the action to our second contest of the afternoon. Entering the back row in the cage first, into the red corner, make some noise for Hassan Ahmed.
Hassan Ahmed, 5-1, Steve, what a record.
Yeah, he's a real beast out of the Blood, Sweat and Tears Camp BST, just out of Northampton. Danny Vatten, Raymond Paul in the corner there. And they.
If you're interested on finding out a little bit more about our man, Hassan Ahmed, he was on the Fisticuffs podcast as a sponsor of this show. And, I gave it a little listen. He's very interesting. He was talking about he loves the lifestyle of being a fighter. That everything that goes with it, the camp, the cutting weight, the camaraderie, the dedication, you know, brings back the kind of mental images of a samurai meditating below a waterfall. That's our man, Hassan Ahmed.
Exactly. And he's taken it everywhere. He's had some decisions. He's had some finishes. He's able to move in all sorts of positions. And the best thing about this is that the lighter weights at Blood, Sweat and Tears Academy, BST, they're just stacked right now. They've got so many fighters on so many different promotions, from the amateur all the way to the highest levels of the professional mixed martial arts world. And that is where Ahmed is cutting his teeth. That's where he's learning his trade. This is going to be his seventh fight. He's already taken one L. He knows the bitter taste of defeat, and you know he's going to want to avoid that. You know, sometimes when it's just when you're 3-0, 5-0, 6-0, you don't know what defeat tastes like, so you're not going to fight like a caged animal. Well, I know Ahmed is going to, and he's got a powerful beard, that's for sure. So the 66-kilo featherweight division is being explored in these first two fights here. Maybe we're going to see who's going to be heir apparent to fight Karim next. We could actually pair these guys up later on.
Yeah, 2-0, Mr. Callum Deacon, representing Eclipse Wolverhampton as a Gracie Jiu-Jitsu gym, and he's had two submissions, so we know he's dangerous on the floor.
Exactly, two in a row, two submissions. Again, hasn't tasted defeat yet, and we've seen him fight before. He's just, you know, comes in very, very good shape. Both of these guys are going to be long, rangy featherweights, and it's going to be, you know, I love to say it's who's going to be their fastest with the mostest. Who's going to come in and make the other respect them early and then get the setup? This is going to be good times. And I love the featherweight division because it's got the speed of the lower weights. It's got a bit of power there, and there's a lot of mystique to these guys.
And I was watching Callum Deacon's fights last night prepping for this show, and I was just so blown away by the smoothness of his transitions. And it's a Gracie Jiu-Jitsu gym over at Eclipse, but he's got that thing of like just beautifully transitioning to Neon Belly, beautifully transitioning to Mountain, that kind of Gracie Jiu-Jitsu thing of, you know, slowly improving position, being dominant, controlling every position as we go. And he is so good. You know, he's actually got a win over ballerina standout Haider Ali.
First, the fights are in the red corner, weighing 66.4 kilograms, representing BST Academy. Make some noise for Hassan Ahmed. And his opponent, the fighter in the blue corner, weighing 65.4 kilograms, representing Eclipse Kickboxing and Gracie Jiu-Jitsu. Make some noise for Callum Deacon.
So we have Ahmed in the lightning bolt shorts, this and is Deacon a bit, in the black shorts.
This is a bit different from our first fight. Both of these guys look a bit more nervous, whereas we had much more chill in action last time.
Yeah, this is so interesting because Deacon has had such smooth submission victories, but we know that Ahmed trains with three of the country's best black belts.
And look at this, though. We're seeing a lot more calm here in the striking exchanges. Ahmed catches early. Yeah, Deacon looking for a guillotine choke, maybe just to say, hey, this is my world.
Yeah, I thought that my prediction was that Hassan Ahmed would try and keep this on the feet and turn this into a kickboxing match.
Obviously, if Deacon's been great and slick off of his back, but he's really heavy on that head, that's not exactly the nicest position to be in early on in the fight. Getting a lot of pressure there on the neck. He's just bothering him a few knees up the middle.
Yeah, Ahmed did a good job of sneaking his head out from under his armpit. Now it's all about head position, controlling this battle against the cage.
I like how he's making it dirty against the cage, is Ahmed, with knees to the thighs.
That's the head position you like, things. Steve.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's the difference between one of these professional gyms with a lot of experience and some gyms that just don't quite have that. That pressure there, you know, you got Sam Creasy, who's the flyweight Cage Warriors champion, flyweight world champion of Cage Warriors, and he was the one that showed me that years ago that you got to own every single position. And we see Deacon go back to that head wrap, bothering with that guillotine position. He gets tripped in hard. Arm in guillotine, and Ahmed passes it out. Gets his head out.
This is interesting because Deacon's got closed guard. We know that he's good from this position. He can throw up submissions, but the issue is that he's up against the cage. So it just makes it harder to angle off all the time.
He's walking those legs up, though.
Yeah. Ahmed being good, being patient, keeping low.
Head
not
in the middle of the chest.
Position. Yeah. This is what we see from the BST guys. Just polished.
Lovely little pop up there. Body head. A lot of things don't change. It's just how tight they are and how good they are. Everything has trickled down here. So this level that we're seeing now is indicative of the professional level 10 years ago.
Oh, beautiful little pass there. Really? Deacon,
and now look, there's your stack. There's your double leg stack there, a la Khabib Nurmagomedov. And he's got that there. And even though it's looking like Deacon's sitting up here, he's got a lot of pressure there, and he's owning it.
Deacon did a really good job of getting his back to his feet.
And the knee up the middle. Deacon did not like that one.
Already, Deacon has had more difficulty in this fight than his last two performances
put together.
Yep.
This is exactly what you want. You want to come up the ranks. You want to have these kind of questions asked. Do the whole every single time you're getting punched, taken down, the question being asked is, do you really want this? Is this where you are? Do you want to be a fighter? Everybody says they want to be. And it's who stays there until the end, who keeps fighting to the very end.
I don't want to be anymore, Steve. I'm quite over it. I used to do it.
It was a lot of fun back in the day.
My back hurts me.
There we go, last 10 seconds. And Ahmed doing very well. Again, talking about cage control, aggressiveness, and damage. We're getting all of those things from Ahmed in the BST corner. But again, a lot of activity there from Deacon. You can't count him out. There's the first round. Let's shake off the cobwebs. Let's get the blood flowing, and let's see what we can do here in the second round. Again, coming down to the corners. If you were in the corner of Deacon, Chris, what are you going to be telling him?
I think for Deacon, if he wants the takedown, he needs to be the one initiating it, shooting underneath. If he's going to end up on his back on that guard position, he needs to make sure he's off the cage to do it. And also, you know, we didn't get to see a lot of striking there. It became a bit of a grappling match, and we know that both fighters actually have got pretty good striking, but Deacon needs to force it a little bit more and get that head position that you were talking about earlier, Steve. And that's why it's not a physicality thing, you know. I don't think Ahmed is particularly stronger than Deacon. That's not the reason he's able to hold him against the cage. It's just a better body position.
Yeah, I like that, Chris. I was coaching little kids jiu-jitsu today, and two kids who were very, very evenly matched. It was who went first. It was actually my daughter getting actually absolutely turfed by this other kid who's the same size as her, but he's just initiating fast. And as soon as you get somebody on the back foot, you have that momentum going forward, and that's what we saw Ahmed do so well. So Deacon, listen to the corner of Chris, fence him over here, and get yourself moving faster. Forward faster. Make your decisions. You got the haircut for it, big guy.
If Deacon can get this fight to the floor with him on top, he looks so good in his last fight.
I don't like that. I don't like risking the kick to the upper body there. Yeah. Really. I want him kicking to the open side. I think that's where Deacon can do some damage. See there, another catching of the kick, and that's how you're going to drive him backwards. Deacon, the southpaw as well, and he's circling to the power of Ahmed. He's doing himself a disservice. Good head movement from Ahmed.
What Steve's mean is generally for the southpaw, you want to step to the outside of the leg. Oh, this is good for Ahmed. Going to get a takedown. Big. Well, not that big, but he got a takedown.
Could have done. And now he's in that leg weave position.
Yeah, what Deacon needs to do is get onto his other side just like that. He's turning onto his right-hand side, and then he's going to be trying to drag his right leg through. You see him pummeling with his left foot there, trying to make space so that then he can pull his right leg through.
I think we're going to see some lockdown maybe.
Yeah, looks like he's looking for it, Steve.
There, lockdown. I'm going to look over to our 10th Planet team back here.
I'm not the biggest fan of lockdown when you're getting hit in the head.
That?
Oh, look, nice, Steve. He's got that knee and he's
using
got
it to elevate. Oh, he's got a Bronx choke.
What's arm in? Like, yep, Bronx choke.
That's very tight. If he can start squeezing and driving away, he could lock up those hips. I think if he can go back to the lockdown, he can start pulling Ahmed's hips back and get stronger squeeze on that. Yeah, so Deakins...
he's going to struggle to get the squeeze from this bottom position, but that was so sneaky, Steve. I didn't even see that coming.
Might just use this to stand up, which I think is what he's trying to do at the moment. Oh. He's running that way. It's hard. Again, you said in the first fight, Chris, it's really hard with these gloves because they're quite thick, and you see the fingers of Deakin over.
Nice.
Now he's on top.
That's what he wanted. Oh, he's sitting back for it, Steve. He's trying to roll him over the top. Oh, lost
slides
it.
Slides out.
And I appreciate the effort.
Watch those knees to the back there because it might be a spine spike. And now Ahmed's all over him here. Again, I've seen Ahmed go right back to the knees on the thighs here. He loves doing damage there. Ahmed is an opportunist, man. Every little opening you give him, he's going to take. But then again, Deakin the same. Little opportunity there. He's looking for a Kimura trap, maybe.
And this is why Ahmed has gone 5-1. Possibly 6-1 tonight if he can get the win. It's just he's very composed. He listens to his corner. He's not emotional. He does everything right.
Yeah, no, there was no anxiety there in that position. He was calm. He was driving forward.
Kimura
There's
trap.
Your Kimura trap.
But gave up his back.
If he can keep his hands... Oh, yeah. Just didn't quite have it. Again, those gloves, difficult to hold on to. And now we've got...
We are seeing some beautiful...
Both hooks in.
Grappling by Deakin,
but stretching him out here. Stretching him out and staying on top. Can he do some damage? There's 10 seconds left. I think he's... Didn't quite hear the clapper. He's still trying to stretch him out. And there you go. A couple punches there to end the second round.
Well, a very interesting round, Steve. That Bronx choke really changed things.
It was a moment to scramble, I think, and Deakin just didn't use that opportunity to get it back up and get comfortable. And again, he just loses kind of the territorial battle. Ahmed takes him down. Ahmed stays on top and finishes on top. And even though you have that little bit of a threat there from the Bronx choke earlier on, it doesn't come to any sort of damage or any fruition there.
What do you think the corners are going to be saying to them, Steve? What little adjustments should they be making?
For Deakin? Oh, my gosh. For Deakin, honestly, I've seen a lot of this...
Hail Marys.
No. I think you go back to the basics. I've seen a lot of this pitter-patter striking. I want to see you chin down behind your front, behind your right shoulder, looking to jab and come forward. Bothering Ahmed, jabbing and stepping out to your right, away from Ahmed's power, so he steps into your left. So the right, pop, pop, give him something that stings and make him sit on the left. Make him respect you, and then take him down and try to finish on top, because I think that's the only way that you can pull this from the jaws of defeat, because right now, you're almost getting swallowed by Ahmed. You're right in the back molars at the moment. Can you pull yourself from the jaws of defeat and get victory? It's all on you now, Deakin. Touch of gloves. Now watch. Has Deakin made... No, Deakin's falling. Again, he's dancing to the tune of Ahmed. He's circling to the left instead of over off to his right where he knows he needs to be. And he's stepping forward, chin up.
Yeah, just Ahmed's got the better shape. Shape and form. That's what my old boxing coach used to shout.
And look at Ahmed's head movement. There you go. Boom. Look at that. Lovely. Steps back in. You see, he's slick. He's relaxed. Deakin is still tense here.
I know there. Some great boxing coaches over at BST. Look at that head movement, Steve. He slipped 3 shots in a row.
And he landed a right. Short right, but he landed it.
Ahmed's just putting on a clinic.
Again, no anxiety here. He's taking his time to get his hands together. Head position's good. And the head position against the fence again. We see that the posture's just broken there of Deakin, so it's all being run. He's dancing to the tune of Ahmed.
Yeah, I feel like Deakin needs to throw up something. Maybe try and get in the middle
or
of the cage.
Get thrown up. God,
that's not what he wanted to be thrown up by, Steve.
Beautiful. Beautiful. And we've seen that from a lot of BST fighters, that strong clinch, hips in.
Oh, beautiful recovery there by Deakin. Gets back to a butterfly. Now he's on top a little bit. Dig in under that chin again, Steve.
He rushed it a bit. Rushed it. Did
we know he is so dangerous with these chokes.
Yep, nice. Yep, good for Ahsan. Just getting his head in the middle of the chest of Deakin. Now he's back in the head position. Good, strong body lock. And, I love that. That overhook into the crotch right there. He's controlling the hips of Deakin so that Deakin can't form up any offense in terms of knees. And then he can sneak his own knee up into the middle of the solar plexus.
This has been a little bit of the Ahsan Ahmed show this fight so far, but Deakin has showed some beautiful escapes, transitions, just jiu-jitsu, really. He's so dangerous, even off his back, even the bottom of side control.
He's still there all this time in. 8 minutes into the fight, and he's still there. This is a good time to let you know that we're brought to you by Supology, Power Grip, performance and sport.
Do you know Power Grip have got a stall at the back here, Steve? Battlerina branded Power Grip stuff.
I can't wait.
I want some. Yeah, we must get free gear, right?
And Eric's fight gear. I need to get some Eric's fight gear.
Good
but
stuff.
But now 40 seconds left. Ooh. And look at that. Ooh, I felt that one. Right into the IT band.
This is smart as well. Ashenhammer knows he's two rounds up. He doesn't want to take any big risks, you know, trying to go for a knockout at this point or a big takedown or submission. You can just tire him out, wait out the last 20 seconds.
Whereas the opposite's true for Deacon. He needs to be throwing up something.
Yeah, he's got to try and force the action.
And that time just winds down. This is when Deacon's corner should be shouting at him, telling him what the time is, what
he's
to be doing.
Around the neck. 10 seconds
around
he
the
goes.
Neck. 10 seconds, he can't rewrap that, can't get the choke. And Deacon ends up scoring again, Ahmed gets again scores with the takedown. A really good display there of how important cage wrestling is, or cage grappling is, that upper body clinch in this arena of mixed martial arts. We had some very strong, very relaxed kickboxing in this fight as well. It was nice to see both fighters relaxed in that situation. Yeah. I would have loved to see them just kickbox it out for a little while longer to see who could be more dominant. There you got the big pick by Ahsan Ahmed. Big pick and big slam with a head right in the middle. And I know that didn't look like it hurt, but that would have shaken me up. And Deacon did really well to recover there and stay in the game. So kudos to both fighters, and we're going to go to that kind of decision in a moment.
There's a little moment there, Steve, where Ashenhammer slipped four or five punches in a row and then just pivoted out to the side. It was just such smooth striking, such a great demonstration of being calm and controlled and having great technique. And like, he needs to put that in slow motion and stick that as his Instagram reel for the day, and all the chicks are going
to
be after him.
I bet you everyone wants to be in the Matrix, and Ahsan Ahmed certainly was there. Just a no-touch, no-dice, not coming for me, can't touch this kind of approach. And Ahsan Ahmed knows exactly what's happened tonight, and so does Deacon. Here we go for the official announcement.
So after three rounds of action, we're going to the judges for a decision. And all three judges had it for a unanimous decision for the fighter in the red corner. And please make some noise for your runner, Callum Deacon.
I think Ashwin Ahmed is not actually very happy with his performance there, Steve.
I am not
like
impressed with my own performance. I wanted to finish him. And, you know, that's the hunger that you need at this amateur level. It is never good enough. You can step out there and smash somebody with the right hand, knock him out immediately. It's never good enough. You want to keep building on this experience. And Callum Deacon, you know, he gets that experience here. He gets his first L. It sucks. It tastes like crap. But you know what? You'll be back out. I know you will, Callum, because even in that ninth minute, you were fighting. Yeah. Good on you.